Welcome to V8 Nation, talking all things motorsport with Rick Kelly and Paul Dumbrell.
Hello everybody and welcome to V8 Nation with Rick Kelly and Paul Dumbrell. As always, a big week in the world of motorsport and we're going to get stuck into it over the next 60 minutes. Grant from speedcafe.com to join us. A very special guest in the studio as well. We have Rick Kelly here to my left, the angriest man in V8s to my right, Paul Dumbrell. Firstly, before we get to PD, because he is filthy about everything at the moment. How you doing, Rick?
Very well, thank you.
Rico, how you feeling, mate? It's good to see you joined us from last week. No show.
That's right. I had a week off. No, I gave you a little bit and I tried to get a replacement. Yeah, I lost my voice, so you would have probably preferred to have me in the studio like that, no doubt.
That would have been a perfect week for you to come in, to be honest.
All right, before we get stuck into the massive week it was in Tasmania and some good results from PD, both on and off the track. Don't forget, boys, we do it all thanks to Spitwater High Pressure Cleaners, built here in Australia for nearly 30 years and still going strong. When you need a serious cleaner with real muscle, Spitwater, that's what it does. And I know you have one, PD, because you had one out last week cleaning your car. Did a wonderful job. Make sure if you haven't got one, spitwater.com.au, you do check it out. PD, it might be the one way to relax you right now to get your old Spitwater high pressure cleaner out, because you are filthy about nearly everything. What's going on?
Mate, I don't know, really. You know, I guess I've gone through Shane Van Gisbergen. That's been the last month, I guess, me slagging him, unfortunately. But, no, it's disappointing to end the weekend and jump on the plane on Sunday night and see an article on Speed Cafe, our one and only Speed Cafe, from my teammate, actually. And I'll read it. Winterbottom left to rue Dumbrell battle. Well, last time I checked, motor racing was a battle. And, you know, if someone's actually, you know, behind you, last time I checked, you don't pull over and let them through, which I think maybe he intended. But, no, hey, we're all teammates, both Will, myself and Frosty. You know, Will first, second, and I think Will was fourth at the time. Absolutely, you know, I was driving pretty hard to try to keep in front of Frosty. But, you know, we're in the lead of the race. It's not as though we're battling for 10th and 12th, down the grid. So, once again, I read that, and, you know, he sort of said, you know, his car was impeded by, you know, being behind my car and overheating the brakes. But as I said, you know, we're in a motor race, and unfortunately, that's what it's about. You know, if he wanted to pass me, I guess he could have, and I think he wasn't actually happy with my passing move on him down into the hairpin, which he got back past me because I made a mistake. I actually only went down to second gear rather than first gear in the hairpin. But, mate, it was a pretty, pardon the pun, frosty way to win the race. It was pretty cold at the airport. But, hey, Rico can back me up, mate.
I think Frosty is a good bloke.
Mate, so do I. I've got nothing wrong with Frosty at all. It's just it's disappointing. But, you know, he's moved into third in the championship. He's the lead car behind, I guess, Team Vodafone, which is probably the winner of the championship outside the best team in the competition, really.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think the article's actually that bad. I mean, the headline always makes it sound a little worse than what it is. But he's quite...
I probably should read the article then.
Yeah, well, you haven't read the article.
Stop at the headline. Did you add anything, Grant from speedcafe.com to join us shortly? Did you add anything? Did you get on the phone to Grant and say, oh, I've got a few words of my own?
If it was anyone other than my teammate, I might have gone a little bit harder. No, Grant and I have a great relationship, and we've said a few things which have generated a bit of publicity for the show, for V8 Nation, which you can check us out at V8 Nation on Twitter, which is great. So just doing your job there, Cam, which is great to see.
It's only taken you 27 shows to realise what our Twitter handle is, so I do appreciate that. You can also get in contact with us, V8Nation@crocmedia.com. Rico, just on that, teammates come out and given his teammate and Paul Dumbrell a bit of a spray. Is that on? Would you spray one of your teammates, even though he might have aggrieved you in one way?
We would never speak to... one another in that manner. That's just atrocious, to be honest with you. I mean, on the Ford side of the fence, it's obviously how they go about things. It goes from Shane Van Gisbergen to internally now in his team to Winterbottom. Now, look, to be honest with you, it's a very good point, because the cars are obviously within a team very evenly matched, so you always end up racing each other on the track. Now, like PD said, or like Frosty pointed out on there, once you're behind a car for a little bit of time at Simmons Plains, your brakes fade very, very quickly. So obviously Frosty at that point was keen to get by PD and extend his lead. But once you're up the front, it's anyone's game, isn't it? Like if you prefer between first and third, you do not let anyone pass under any circumstances, even if it's at the start of the race or at the end. You'd prefer to come in, even if it's against what the team have instructed you, you'd prefer to come in at the end and go, yeah, okay, I'm sorry about that, but, you know, that's my trophy and you haven't got one, sort of thing. You know what I mean? Like, it's so hard to get a win or get a podium in this category that you cannot let one slip from that point of view. But it's an interesting thing, and you do need to work with your team from time to time.
We've seen it in Formula One over the years, boys, where a teammate will pull over for another teammate to go by for maybe getting a higher point or winning getting on the podium if you're the higher ranked teammate. Is that maybe starting to creep into V8s? Did Frosty's going and now is in the third position on the table? Did he think that as a teammate, someone who's not highly ranked should maybe move over and help him achieve the best possible season ranking?
Hey, we're always going to look after each other. Like, at the end of the day, though, if my car's really struggling, I'm wounded, or our tyre life isn't going well, of course, you know, we would make it easier for our teammate to pass than maybe someone else. But then they win the lead of the race. Our car was reasonably quick. Frosty was all over us for maybe 5 or 10 laps, and we managed to pull, you know, a second, maybe 3/4 second of a lead, and then he sort of got back to me within the last 5 laps of the stint. Once again, you know, he could have passed. And, you know, obviously I'm not going to turn in on a teammate at all. Not like what Rico does to obviously the fellow V8 Nation host.
True.
Done it twice this year, let me remind you.
Still a couple of rounds to go as well.
Oh, no.
If I was in the wrong, though, I would have got penalised.
Yeah.
Well, should we actually go to stewards and actually talk about what we actually did to not get you penalised?
I don't think we should bring that up again, or your bike
this is actually on YouTube as well.
It's okay for PD. He's finished in 2 weeks' time.
Hey, Mr. Woolerman.
Something that has been missed a little bit, though, by the fact of what's happened after with the winter bottom situation is that you drove particularly well all weekend, PD, and you always seem to drive very well at Tassie, as we found last week. It was the start of your first race, also your first podium last year. And again, you did a very good job on the weekend.
Mate, it was really good. From a team perspective, I had a lot of confidence going down there from last year's speed. We were quickest all day Friday, pretty much. Saturday qualifying was a little bit disappointing, but such a close qualifying session. The race didn't go exactly to plan, to be honest. Unfortunately, I had a bit of a run-in with the stewards, which wasn't, or the officials, which wasn't ideal in qualifying, potentially holding up another car. And then Sunday, you know, good to get pole, and we led first 20
potentially
laps.
Holding up another car. That car had 4 wheels locked to avoid hitting him and another guy and ended up in the grass backwards.
Who was it?
Stephen Johnson.
He was potentially held up.
He was last on the grid before that, and he was last afterwards. So
that was his fly. I would have put him on pole.
Yeah, absolutely. I would have won the race as well if I didn't spin.
But it's a good point. I mean, PD was very quick there last year. He got his first podium and I think qualified quite high. But again, on the weekend, PD got himself up the front with a pole position. And it's a tough track. I mean, I think on the Saturday, was it PD or the Sunday? From first to last, there was 0.7 seconds covering the whole field. And normally the last few cars actually drop off on pace. So it would have been, you know, 0.5 seconds from first to 20th.
Well, Davo, like Will Davison, our teammate, he was probably the most bereaved. He was fifth. And he was 5/100ths off pole.
Oh,
like, you know, Frosty was second and he was 2/100ths off pole, which you can sort of maybe cop first to second because it is close. To be fifth and only be 0.5 of 1/10 or 5/100ths off pole, it was incredible. And, you know, I guess that just showed how close all the cars were. And for our team, FPR, to have second, third and fourth at the end of the race, I think we qualified first, second and fifth. It was great for the team. You know, it would have been good to at least have one of the cars win or all 3 cars on the podium, which I don't think has ever happened in V8 Supercars.
No, definitely.
We're pretty close. Effort. So, hey, we're rolling into Sandown this week. We're actually looking forward to getting down there and hopefully having another good run.
Why is it that you drive so well in Tassie? Why do you think it is?
Oh, just because I want to, you know. I thought I might actually, you know.
You don't care the other time?
No, I thought I might just do something finally in my career. So, no, I don't. I think the track suits our cars and suits me certainly as well. I'm, you know, hard breaker. The track is, you know, with the hairpin and also turn 6, incredibly tough on the brakes. And we've had a pretty good braking package this year. So it suits our cars. And, you know, it's an engine-based track, like a grunt-based track. So we've actually had a fair bit of engine work done this year. We debuted a new spec engine before the Phillip Island race this year, which has worked a treat for us.
And obviously to Sandown this weekend, where you scored your first V8 Supercar victory, probably, hopefully for us, not your second and third this weekend.
We should talk about that. It was quite funny. We were watching the Vision last year, and Rico had a mechanical problem. That was at Sandown, wasn't it? Yeah, he had a mechanical problem and he was in the garage and Channel 7, came in and interviewed Rick in his door and they're like, oh, you know, mate, you know, tough day. And Rick's like, yeah, you know, it's a tough day. You know, obviously we're out of the race, but, you know, we'll try to repair it, get back out of there. But, gee, PD's going, well, it looks like he's going to win his first race.
That's right. I think that was at Sandown. And the front of the car was on fire.
Everyone's like, hey, what's this bloke?
Well, before we get into Sandown, talk a little bit about that. Jason Bright, what's the deal with his injury, Rico?
I only read it on Speed Cafe on Saturday night. So it said from that he had a rib injury. It said in there, quoted him saying that he had damage at the Phillip Island event. And then he sort of nursed it for a bit.
Doing driver changes.
Yep. Someone actually on the weekend said that he injured it really badly in a go-kart. But that, I think that that's just a rumour. But certainly said on there that he injured it at Phillip Island. He's nursed it from then. And then in the race, it got quite bad. Because I actually saw at one point in the race, he came from a long way back because he qualified poorly, right up onto us in the last three or four laps. And then all of a sudden, he disappeared again, which is obviously when that got aggravated and a little worse. So I saw him after try and get out of the car after qualifying Sunday, when he qualified, I think, second last. And you could see he was in some trouble. And then before the race, we're standing there, look down the end of pit lane, and he's standing there, Cameron McConville's standing there in his race suit. So obviously that's who's driving the car. And to be honest,
Cam did a good job.
He did a good job. I mean, to come to an event and never driven their car, or not for several years anyway, so to be quite different, haven't driven at that track for several years, to jump in and drive around to the grid and start the race with zero practice, zero laps, in someone else's setting position, someone else's car, that's very, very difficult. And there was a couple of times during that race I was actually on the opposite side of the hairpin to him, and he was lapping every bit as quick as I was. So that was a pretty good effort.
Hey, Peter, you remember about 3 weeks ago on V8 Nation, and we said to Rico, we've heard some rumours about you test driving the car of the future.
Yes,
and he said, I don't know about that. If they call me, it'll be an honour and all the rest of it. And then the next day, just pops up on speedcafe.com some photos of him at the test day. Remember that?
I was quite honoured.
It's happened a few times this year. You know, we're at the Stig. Not that he actually came out and drove for him. Grant Denyer, maybe even coming on the show.
Yeah.
I don't even know if Rick actually met Grant Denyer at all. Like, did you actually ever see him in the filming of the show?
I think he was there.
He certainly hasn't returned your phone call.
Yeah, because remember Grant was going to be on this show, and he was going to talk to us all about Shannon's Supercar Showdown. And he wasn't allowed to talk to anyone else.
I did try.
Yeah, seems like it. Always... All right, car of the future, mate. How was it? Can you tell us about it now, or is it still high secret?
I can tell if you want, but it's going to cost you $50.
Off you go, then. PD can pay.
Yeah, look, it was a big honour for me to be invited down and test not only the car and the Car of the Future platform that we're going to race on, but also a number of new Dunlop tyres in both the 17-inch, which is what we're currently running on now, and the 18-inch, which we'll go to in a couple of years' time. And it was very enjoyable not only to drive that new car, but also go to a new team that ran the car and learn the way they operate and just be removed from our team for a couple of days and go down there.
You actually knew a few people from that team, didn't you?
Well, actually, the engineer that ran the program was Sweno, that I'd worked with for 2.5 years.
And when did he leave?
After Clipsal this year.
What type of relationship ending was it? Was it a good one, was it?
Yeah, it wasn't too bad. I mean, Sweno's a good guy. I got a lot of respect for him, and I enjoyed working with him for the 2 years. I can see you guys both. Don't forget there's two cameras in here picking up all the laughing in the background.
I noticed the article that said, Rick, it was good to catch up with him, but I thought you might
have
let it go.
It was very good to work with Sweno for those 2 days. Stop laughing at me. Genuinely was. And they did a good job of engineering the car. It's a little bit different to what we've dealt with now. It feels a little bit nicer, particularly obviously around the cornering. It's got a lot of rear grip and a lot better power down. And looking forward to driving that in a little bit over 12 months.
Just before we get into an ad break, you weren't here last week because you were sick or had the illness, or I don't know where you were, but we had John Bow on. Well,
yep.
Tasmanian motorsport legend.
Yeah,
should have heard him, and he was great to chat to. He was nearly begging PD not to hang up the helmet and to go on next year.
I saw it on Speed Cafe. An article says PD retires too late.
Yeah.
Or too early.
Too early. Shane Van Gisbergen said it was too late, but we'll see how it goes. V8Nation at crocmedia.com if you'd like to get involved. Don't forget, boys, pressure clean to the max with Spitwater, the fast and efficient way to clean up. You probably know someone that has one. I know you have
one,
PD.
I'll tell you what.
Do you have one?
I got a lot of pressure washers. Now, after Tassie, I'm sure you would have needed one because I saw probably 3 or 4 times you'd buried quite deep in the dirt on the Exeter 2.
Yeah, mate, absolutely, mate. I was on polo in the same session.
I'm damn sure it's not you that cleans a car.
That's correct.
Well, if you don't have one, you got to get one. Spitwater.com.au. Make sure you jump on, check it out. Spitwater, that's what it does. We're going to take a very quick break. Plenty more V8 Nation with Rick Kelly and Paul Dumbrell on the way.